No NFL rivalry may ever quite duplicate the curious love-hate relationship between the Steelers and Oilers of the late 1970s.
The team that I always was the sores, you know, like Monday morning when I got up, that I felt the sores, was always the game after we played the Houston Oilers. That was always a very physical, physical game.
They were hard to beat. They were as much like the Steelers as the Raiders were. Real tough, physical football team. But they also represented everything about football that I liked.
Love Terry Bradshaw. My kind of guy. Country, not real smart, but a great, great player. He's kind of like Earl and Dan, and he's like one of our kids. But our players and their players got along really, really well, other than when the game was going on. In fact, one year we knocked Cincinnati out of it, and Pittsburgh got in it. Otherwise, we wouldn't have beat Cincinnati the last game of the year. They wouldn't have gotten in the playoff. And then after the season, they sent all the players and all the coaches a briefcase. It wasn't full of money, though.
Pittsburgh wasn't as friendly when dismantling Houston for the conference crown. But in the 79 rematch, the Oilers proved a much tougher foe.
As Bradshaw calls the signals and drops back for the Pittsburgh Steelers, they can't get to him. He fires the pass, intercepted at the 25, back over the 30, the 35, the 40. Here they come. It's Vernon Perry with the ball, the 50, the 40, the 30. He's down to the Pittsburgh 20, the 15, the 10. He's going all the way for a Houston touchdown. Vernon Perry.
But the Steelers bounced back and took a 17-10 lead on the strength of two touchdown passes.
Bradshaw with plenty of time, lets it go down the middle. Touchdown, Pittsburgh! Listen to this crowd!
Look at those tablecloths flying, you betcha!
Late in the third quarter, the Steeler lead was still only a touchdown when Houston mounted an impressive drive. It centered almost entirely around their crafty possession receiver, Mike Renfro, number 82.
I think on the next play we threw long, and as the ball was going over my head, Mel Blount sort of ran over the back of my heels, and I did a little acting job and got a pass interference call. The next play I caught a little 15-yard in pattern, and looking back on it, I was a pretty tired football player by then, being sort of the vocal point of the drive when Dan called my number one last time.
We were trying to hit the fade, a little quick fade. We just take two steps back and let the ball fly, and it's a timing pass. And it was a one-on-one situation, and I felt that he was the best possession guy at that particular moment to catch the ball, and he made a great catch. Clearly came down in possession and with his both feet in inbounds. Unfortunately, they ruled it a non-catch, and that kind of killed our momentum and ended the game.
And I came up and saw a starry-eyed referee who we looked eye to eye for a few seconds, and I saw the blank expression on Mr. Orr's face. He just didn't make a call.
We didn't have the cameras and the slow-mo and the instant replay and all that stuff, but from on the sidelines, you couldn't see it. It was too quick, too close. But when they slowed it down now and you could see it, yeah, he was in by like 4 inches. So, yeah, he caught it. It was a touchdown. What are you gonna do?
I spoke with Jim Tunney, who made that call, or I think a week later, when he said that he felt that he caught the ball. And I said, well, that's a week later and a dollar short, but I know it would have put us back in the game. Gave us something to go on, gave us a motivating factor.
Houston left the field thinking that they should have won it because of a controversy, and that cast shadow doubt on the game. I'm a sportsman. I've always been a sportsman. I like to compete. I don't want to have any unfair advantage. Give them the touchdown. We'll still beat your tail.
A pair of late scores sent the Steelers to their fourth Super Bowl. But even more significant was the game's impact on the future of the NFL.
It did bring to us the realization that it's too much to ask a man on the field who might not be in exactly the right place to make a call on something that we have a hard time making a call on when you look at it on instant replay. So that when the instant replay issue came up, that was one of the prime examples.
Involved in the play, you'd think maybe my opinion would be different, but it's a human game. I like to see it refereed by the humans, and certainly we're all going to make mistakes. We still had to overcome a great, great football team, and I'm not so sure that we would have defeated them anyway.